guys, welcome to another episode of the Sputnik Challenge for Workers and Resources, Soviet Republic. This is episode 54. My name is Kaya Maya, and I said in the last episode that I wanted to go into the comments of Forcium. And I have two things to say. One, I think I pronounced your name Verizon, and it's Forcium. I'm sorry about that. And the other one is, when I say it sucks, it was meant to be a little bit with a wink-wink and not very serious because, they do work. But I will want to read your comment first. And he said, let me share my experience with ORF pronunciations. I do not use any fancy tricks and still do not see that they would be somewhat broken. Let me give you some context. My republic is now 45k population. I have 4 prisons. 3 of them are vanilla and 1 is a bit smaller modded. Those are filled to about 75%. Besides that, I have only 3 orphanages which are operating at maximum capacity and they're fully supplied, which is about 420 orphans. I have 50% loyalty threshold for workers in orphanages and accept loyalty and increased alcohol addiction. I can keep orphans happy and healthy enough with low crime rates as crime among orphans is not rising. I know you cannot get all stats positive, but you can still have some orphans saved and they can become productive and useful workers. But of course, if I would like to keep all orphans, then it would be a problem. But why would I do that? Well, my answer to that is that for me, keeping all orphans is kind of vital because otherwise I would feel I would do a half-assed job kind of thing. So what I did in this map, and I didn't have a clue about crime because I used to just reset crime level back then. The last time I played this was in July last year, I think. So I first create in my first city this orphanage. This was full in no time. And then I added another one, also full in no time. So then I thought, well, okay, the next city I'm going to add a couple of orphanages to begin with. These are modded ones. Those were not enough. And I had to add and also the number of tutors here. And so and then at the next city, I thought, excuse me, let's make an orphan city here. But still, that wasn't enough because I have now 74,000 people, but all these orphanages are full. And also they are being influenced badly, but that's probably because I don't pay attention to, yeah, I have it set up differently. But that was the issue. There are never enough orphanages. And the last city, let me see, that was here. I think I stopped here. Yeah, it looks like I stopped here. Oh no, I have an orphanage there. And then I thought, well, okay, no. And also, and that's why I have the notifications on, because the last time I played this, you couldn't turn off the orphans, not enough tutors notification. So that was for me the idea. Well, there's never enough I could create to save them all. But if you leave or save them all, but if you are not into it, the system in itself works perfectly. That I do not have an issue. But you need so many of them for, well, I have 75,000 people. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 plus 4. 9, 10, it's I think 11 orphanages I have before I stopped. Excuse me. And the people are divided on, there are 3 more cities. Well, here are only one. There are a couple of more cities here, which are pretty big because these are the noble. Oh, they're empty. Okay. Anyway, that's what I wanted to show, and I wanted to go back to my own play now, and that was the answer I would like to give you. The system in itself works perfectly, but for me it's kind of vital to keep having extra room for orphans who are otherwise evicted or escape or I don't know what they do. Well, they're actually not member of the Republic anymore. So I'll see you and it at our own map. So back in our own map, I have become a little bit wiser since just now, because this is episode 55 and not 54. And the last episode, let's say it wasn't my best episode, because I forgot to put in the thingy here, the three how do you say it, the little pieces of road I removed. I already had removed, so I actually created them to remove them right away. I have talked to the dry dock here, and they promise they won't catch fire before our fire station is done, because that's the issue. And I really hope that you're just speeding up this. And what I also did, and you hadn't noticed, but I wanted to pick up stuff. Did I do that here? No, I did it here. Yeah, I had the stuff. I said to pick it up at the Swifterbond warehouse instead of the custom house. So this is not going to work. This is, and I want it different now. Like so, and this is how it was, because we can. Are you? Let me. You are all busy, right? And you also? Yeah, you also still. Okay. Let me buy. This is a distribution office. Do we have a distribution office for everyone? Damn it! No. I was hoping we would have a free distribution office. So. Covered. You are going to the food warehouse and the prison. Yeah. Ah, that's a shame. I wanted to have a distribution office here. That we could fill up with vehicles so we can supply our dry dock already. And I don't have any free distribution offices where I can kind of. Now this is the whole reason we need to build some liquid distribution offices, so some real ones, not free ones. Anyway, what are we going to do today? Well, let me see. We do have some vehicles available, I see. How about doing our little piece underwater? And I want to monitor that while you are full, right? Yes. Okay. So you are full. Okay. Let's see how long we can stretch this. So this would be here. Pause you a little bit. You remove. No. Okay. Did we have the biggest one? Okay. Go. And assign all. Sign all. Can I click you? Click you? No. Damn it. I want to set the priority to high. So I assigned you. Plumbing. High. Okay, vehicles are coming, which is excellent. And so, now we don't have the water from here. So you are not producing, so now we are, I think what happens now is first the water which is here is being used, you see it emptying, and then the water from within the houses is being used. So it could be that we don't have any drinking water, but I don't know how to do this differently. I want to... This is more faces. So where are you? You're almost there. Hurry up. Not F3. Yeah, this is exactly what we need right now, right? Why would you go like this Why not take this route? Or here? Oh, because you're going there, probably. Well, this is nerve-wracking. Thank you. How are we? No water. Well, I hope you can hold on for a bit. And workers. So now we're going to get workers here. We really need to do something about this roundabout. Still have water. Can I somewhere, let me just press play. Can I somewhere see here? You can see the water flow. But not the water storage, right? Sewage flow, water pressure. Yeah, there is no pressure. Yeah, that's obvious, but you can't see the storage, okay. So where are the people coming? You are heading to this building. So come on, hurry up. Okay, stage one. Still happy. Drinking water. Well, this stays pretty good, I think. Or are you not drinking? Let me see. No, everywhere I click, you don't seem to mind this. Okay, that's good to know. So now the steel. Sorry for that. Let me drink some coffee. Okay. Well, it's less stressful than I thought. Let's not get ahead of ourselves. I'm sorry about the noise issues yesterday. I had installed DaVinci Broadcast, I believe it's called, and well, that worked not as expected, and there was also some crackling noises I heard. That were not the cracking of my head. That were not brain cracks. That's a song by Tracy Bonham, Brain Crack. So now people. People, where are you? Already here. Oh, this is going quicker. Thank you. Yeah. It's a race against the clock now. Still a bit of a race against the clock. So, now. Look. But I think we did it. Yes. what's the meter doing here? Yeah, it's all right. So, ooh. now you should be empty, right? No, I would have expected that emptier at least. Oh, that's good. Okay. Then now what? I don't have to wonder now what. Why do I have an electricity problem? Because this is too busy still, right? Probably. This is too busy. Let me see. Don't I have any workers here? It's without drinking water still. No vehicles coming in Yeah. We need to finish this one. Because this is a sewage tank. The water tank is busy with these buildings now. So, you go to high. Okay. And you also. My priority. Yeah, it's just waiting until this is done. I can't help this. Well, you're done. That's something. And electricity, are you done? Also not. But you're not assigned everything as well. Go. Oh, you're done. That's good news. That's good news. Okay. So let's go over the comments for a bit. This was sort by first. Okay. Dimitri said, I did compare this video with one before, and this is an improvement. Keep it up. Yeah, I do want to look a little bit about the cracking noise, and I want to do some more tests to see if that really happens with the NVIDIA broadcast. And besides that, I have to record in different channels, because I always have to lower the volume of the background noises. So yeah, thank you. Adam says, off topic. Fantastic to see the farmers doing so well in the swamp German elections. Do I make the swamp joke or don't I? Well, some people know what I'm referring to. Your people will be allowed to eat for a few more years. I really wish this was a joke. Is that true? Am I low on food here? Because I thought this was pretty good. Because we're also exporting, and you're... I don't know if you mean that. Also, we are going to do stuff in this swamp area here. That's why I created that. But I can kind of... Yeah, I can have two. You can please move here already. So I can do stuff here. You go work there and you go work there. Because we're going to build the road to Amsterdam today. Excavator. No. The other one. Bulldozer. So, and you go there. Okay. So, you are almost done. Gregor said, regarding giving the roundabout priority, if you click on a crossroad like you did at 1925, then you have a window for setting the traffic signs. In the upper left corner of this window, there is a plus mark that allows you to connect nodes that are next to each other for getting one main priority direction with several non-prioritized roads coming in from the sides. It works not really perfect, but often it is good enough to use it. I want to look at that. And Adam also said, I found it in the last episode. So if I, for instance, am here and this is the... So I can add you and you. Okay, so then I would want to have two as a no-go. And what is it? One as a... This should be the setting then, right? But now I can't... It needs two main... Oh, two. Wait a minute. Like so. Excellent. Okay, and let me do this for all. And one. Where's number? Wait a minute. I have four. One, two, three. Where's number four? One. Oh, yeah. This is because, well, two you can go. Is this all right? I think. Now you have two main roads. So. Okay. No, I don't want this. How No, unsaved. Again. Add. You. And add. How do I do this? I don't know. Two? Should be a priority. I don't even know why this is a note. Let me... Why... can I upgrade a road here? Alright. This would be a new road. This is a new road. Ugh. Doing it again. Go away. So again, here. Now I have this note. Should I just get rid of it? That's going to be a... Oh. I'm having to wait until we are not so busy here anymore. Okay. This is great. So now I have three notes here. Do I have a note here? No, right? Here. Okay. It's getting weirder now. Go away. Go away. I don't think this is... this is better. Okay, try again. You. Add. You. And... you. So this is the thingy. Okay, and then priority road. Still have four. One, two. Okay, cancel you again. And remove a node. This should be removed probably. Okay, hurry up. Again, this is the node. Add. Let me see. No, this is how it's supposed to be, I guess. I shouldn't add these. Okay. One is a priority. Three is not a priority. Okay. And now you. Yeah, because I'm removing nodes, I don't have to... sign this, I think. One is a priority and three is be polite. Wait. Okay. Here. No. Yeah. This is four. Where's number? Oh, four. Yeah, four doesn't matter. Two. One, do like so. Okay, and the last one. Two is you, like so. Okay, let's see how this goes. And yeah, we could add another. End station, like here or here. We have electricity here. Where's electricity here? Just a second. Substation. You. Oh, there. Well, I can just add an end station and then it's pretty easy in this game to see where electricity is. Bus end station. Yeah, I don't have... Oh yeah, I do have. Okay. Small one is fine. Let's put you like this. Yeah. So this is for the lines for the vehicles coming from there. can use this end station. From here you can use this end station. So you don't get these buses that come here and want to go that way. Okay, let's see if our fire station... Yes, you're done. Excellent. So let's buy some fire trucks. Fire truck. Is our... No, not yet. Our distribution office. What are we going to do? Speed level 12. Yep. Any 13? 6, 12, 10, 8, 8, 6, 8, 10. Well, you're 12, so I hear you. Okay. And we need fuel. Yep. Fuel. Fuel. Well, we deliver the fuel there. And we need to change the line. I am coming back on the power stair now. How do you call this? What Ethan was talking about. I forgot the name. I still haven't had the chance to look at your game. I'm very sorry about that. But we will do that this week as well as the helicopters. What am I doing here again? Oh yeah, yeah. Powers. How we call the moon station? So you are going to have an extra. Do I, or shall I have like two of you? Because it's a lot of buses on this line. Let's have you and you. And create another line for you. You are going there. How many people are there on this bus? Or passengers? Well, it looks pretty small actually. You go away. Yeah, and you do the same. You go away. And here you can get out, please. You can also here get out. Get out. Okay. Is this a line now? Yeah, okay. Excellent. So, now we have people delivered. We have some gas delivered. And it's October. Come on. How long? This is echt annoying. How long it takes. We've been 2 months for this stupid distribution office. And then we're going to have to... This is what's going to happen. We're going to have to buy some buses and stuff. And we want to import from here. So and they're going to have to go all the way here to realize, oh, I've got to import stuff from the border. Yes. And also, oh yeah, we need to have... how do you say this? Fuel. But that's how the game works, right? You're also not done, so we don't even have electricity here yet. But we're almost there, hopefully. Okay. Well, but what is done is this. Look, it's done. I think this looks amazing. Really amazing. Look, oh, here, still a bit, but, you know, I'm so much looking forward how this will look when it's dark. Can I lower you? No, not really. Yeah. F3, F2. No. What is it? I still have to look at the ID to make here these circles, actually. Got that too. I'm going to look further at the comments because I was doing that before we... But we are very soon fire protected now. Fire trucks. Great, excellent. Okay, back to the comments. I hope we are Because that was I hope. Oh no. No, there's only one solution, and we have to make a road here, which has a direct connection to here, I think. Because what are you? This is all imports, fire trucks. And the reason this is so busy is just the construction. Even maybe have to remove this road at some point. So let's continue with I was with the comment of Gregor, and he said to point to most of the traffic problems you and I too have. Vehicles that want to turn left are causing traffic jams nearly all the time. There is no way around that. I think the game takes too much time for calculating the necessary open space to cross the fluiding traffic. Open space is wide enough that every real-life driver would use it for a go are ignored constantly. Yeah, and I think that's what we're also seeing here, that people, that they are waiting so long. And there's, yeah, I'm calling it polite, but here, why would you wait here? That's like, it's cringe-worthy to look at the traffic sometimes. In his tutorial about public transport, the Dennis showed, well, you did two D's. Well, his channel is also named as 2D's, the Dennis Show. The Dennis showed a layout for a bus end station to avoid exactly that and keeping his traffic run smoothly. What he said has been essential for him and his bigger city layout. I think what you're referring to, what Dennis did, well, let's, where am I? Here. Why, yeah. What Dennis did was have an end station. If traffic is coming from here, have an end station here, have the bus station on the other side, and have the outline going like so. So the traffic never has to cross each other. And that's an excellent design, I think. And that's also one of the reasons why I am now building this one, because then you have the same idea. The traffic doesn't cross each other so often anymore. And I still don't. Look, these are, have been, you know, it's just too much traffic. Or is it still backlog? I think if we make this bypass route, that yeah, the buses will go like this, but it's too busy. Yeah, that's obvious. That's obvious. Thank you, Gregor. Frankie said, just to be polite enough to answer your question at 2050, it was a whole new listening experience. Yeah, and I'm really, really happy that you somehow managed to make it so that the music wasn't affected as well. Yeah, I removed the channel for where I record my UI sound, and I added it again, and I didn't realize that then all channels are marked that the UI sound was recorded, and I noticed that at post-processing. But the question about your introduction regarding the water tower. I really hope there's still enough reserve water in the pipe. Yeah, well, that was pretty close, wasn't it? Adam said, I'm sorry, I'm going to pick up your comment a bit, because this has been, I just showed. He said, he explained how I use the plus button at the junctions here, and also said, well, I found it. And then he said, I don't know if it will help with traffic on this roundabout. It is brilliant for those two-line highway junctions. I have a two-line highway with another two-lane highway crossroad. And on top of that, I use the patented Kaya Maya little corner bits. So I think that single junction has 12 nodes. I have it set up with traffic lights and I have had it set up with priority roads, but I don't know which works best in the end. Katip said, good call on the bypass for construction. Yeah, I'm gearing a lot towards it now. Kuba said, Maya, you have forgotten to deal with water pipes in this episode. Yes, I did. And now I have. As for changes in sound, you sound so much better, though volume may be a bit too high. I am going to have to do some tests with it further, but I want to get rid of the cracking sound. And for that, I think I just want to have some tests and twist and tweak a bit, see if I can get rid of it. As for the prioritizing the important stuff, it may be beneficial to pause the game and think what is actually important part of construction. Embankments would be honestly on the bottom of my list, possibly even suspended for some time to make construction queue clearer. It's a mess right now. That's what I'm saying, not Kuba. So critical infrastructure such as power, sewage, water, as well as fire station. Well, it may be a bit rough. Aircraft production complex is, in my opinion, second of the chopping block right after the embankment. In current situation, production will end at 3 helis for firefighting, as due the aluminum binnen being imported. No heli is eligible for export. Yeah, I wasn't planning on creating my own aluminum, and I wasn't planning on exporting helicopters. The helicopters are purely being used for our own construction office to construct the Sputnik challenge. So there are no there are our first firefighters coming. Excellent. So now we're actually protected. There is no fuel coming. There is fuel coming. Yeah, fuel is on the way. Excellent. And you are right. The embankments are ready, so that should take a load of the list here. So it's I think it's manageable. I will put you to as already on low priority. How long am I in? Let me check for a little bit. 32 minutes. So we have 15 minutes for the road to Amsterdam. Well, that's kind of not so long. And I think the list now is fine. The prefabs. Yeah, I did I set you to see this kind of thing? I should have put you to a high priority to begin with, because now we are 66 people without own flat. That's not what I want to see. And what I'm going to do, this is going to continue as is. I have to add a storage there for the wood. Also, I have to see if you're done. You're done. Let's do this first. And do this first. Only one? No. No. 20 to 3. Okay, and no work can be here now. That's not what I want to see. It's this. It's too much. It's too much, and it's becoming a mess. You're absolutely right. So, workers here. Well, this should cut it, I think. Maximum workers. Excellent. Yeah. So, are workers coming? Oh no, you're not done. Okay, then we were not too late if you're... Oh, you're almost done. So you're done, basically. No, six tons. So yeah, this is almost in production. Then we are creating our own planks. Let's stop importing planks. Don't import boards. Planks, another game. Okay. Back to your comment. I have one question. Do you connect construction with motor roads due to impatience? Sometimes it's much better to wait a bit for road to be made, because once a building starts operating, said road won't be able to be modernized without pain. I connect constructions, like for instance here I did this. I connect them with motor roads, so this road can be created while the mud vote is being done. And what I usually do is once a building is done, like here as well, at some point I just want to see workers work here first, and then I'm going to upgrade it at a time where I don't have a lot of construction going, so it doesn't take so long. And also, I am 100% sure if I create the footpath or the mud road first, then I completely forget about assigning the whole construction. And I think that's my most important reason, that the construction is done. And I also noticed, you know, with recording and stuff, there's just too much going on sometimes. If I play for myself, I'm way more precise than I do here. I forget things all the time, and that just doesn't happen. Like here, I forgot to put in the electricity, and this is also not done. Well, you are still high. Where are my bus groundworks here? What's going on? Yeah, it's a substation. It's we are waiting for this guy to be done, which is almost. Oh, that's the reason we can't have a crane here. That's a shame, actually. And you're almost on. So I'm going to have some comments. What I could have done, which I can't do now, is buy some of the vehicles which we need there, which is an open hull capacity. No, we don't need an open hull. What do we need? A covered hull. Where are you? Covered hull. And then total capacity. Speed, probably. A little bit bigger. How about 1, 2, 3? If I buy 4, all stuff can be delivered. Yeah, I think that's, we have money enough. So now those vehicles are here instead of at the border once this is done. Now it's done, so I could have bought it here, but I can assign you to the... See, this is what I mean. This is going back and forth, you know, no, not one. So yeah, once this is done, which is hopefully not too long from now. What are you doing? What are you doing? Oh? Oh! that's... okay. that was not my intention. No. You two have... I need you here. go home. okay. Back to your comment. And 47:45. Kuba said, to make explaining next paragraph easier, bypass between radio station and new bus and end station sure will reduce congestion on the roundabout by shifting it to that place. Let me go to the roundabout. By shifting it to that place. Main problem with first end station is not necessary that it's after the left turn. The problem is twofold. End station is connected directly to collector road, meaning it's highly utilized road, which means that a lot of trucks will be stopped when the bus tries to enter leave the station. It wouldn't be a huge of a deal, but end station has too little queuing distance, which means that when traffic is stopped, congestion quickly reaches the roundabout and cascades into the whole roundabout jammed. New position for end station is a bit dubious, being placed right off arterial road, but it has enough distance to queue to not reach roundabout. Two locations that are somewhat sensible are next to gas station or the same place old end station is, but rotating it 180 degrees to face north. Longer queuing road and much less traffic than in original position. Another problematic junction is the T between industry area, construction offices and roundabout. Honestly, we just get rid of that and funnel construction vehicles via New Route Between Western COs, Road Cargo Station and Gravel Asphalt Concrete Plant. Yeah, those. I haven't read your comment before I started the episode, but this is a problematic one, and yeah, I think we are going to get around it here, because and maybe this this end station can go, because yeah, this is an issue, but there's too much traffic. It's just during construction, that is, but I want to be able to construct. Oh yeah, we are going, we are 40 minutes in. Okay, then Carlin says, I'm assuming are you using OBS, so there's an option to put audio on separate tracks in the recorded video. This is under the audio mixer with the gear button and can tick where the audio goes in each track and have multiple on one and solo on others. But you also have to go on settings audio, which switch to advanced and on the recording to enable the separate tracks as well, or they'll get discarded. You could have a mixed track, assuming everything goes well, and have separate isolated tracks for each source. So if an audio source changes and is louder than expected, you can just rip the other tracks and use them in post to correct the issue. If it's an FMPG incantation to rip filter option, but your editing software might be able to do it yourself. I always have to adjust my audio levels, and I have my game sounds separate from my voice and the music I add later. So I play without music, and I have one earphone in, so I can hear the game sounds, and for the other I can hear the sounds around me, and also the sounds in my ear make me speak up a little bit more. So that's now. Ethan says, you can only join road segments together when both segments don't have any vehicles on them, and so long as the new segment has beginning and ending node. Yeah, I knew that. I even made a quick tip on that, and I still did it. 2127, the truck wanted to make a left turn and did not have right of way. Yeah, that was the episode of yesterday. The truck that wanted to go, I believe, here. Something, yeah. The oncoming lane had the same priority sign, so it waited until no more vehicles were coming. You might want to have more parallel road to your town. It looks like all the traffic gets rounded through the roundabout. Thank you. What my feeling is now is the episode. Yeah, we need to build stuff, and you know, people are living here, so this is being corrected, and we are finishing stuff, and I need to assign this now. I do feel that reading the comments now is taking a huge chunk of the building time and playing time, which I didn't find an issue now. Because we have so much to construct, and but for episodes like the road to Amsterdam, I see this moving to next episode, because you know, we are 43 minutes in. I have to start assigning this. We have to add a line, creating more vehicles there. Why did I press pause? What would you like me to do is when there are a lot of comments? Would you say, choose a top comment and read that one, or choose a top three, or choose random three? I'm like, you know, if I choose a random three, then some very interesting comments might be left out. But if I choose, I can do two things at the same time. If I choose three comments myself, yeah, then the other people get left out, and I don't like that. So what would you like me to, what would your preference be there? Or what I also can do is import here, you see, deliver there, load there. Okay. What I'm basically asking is, do you find the time that I'm spending on the comments too long? And if so, what would be your solution for that? And I would like it this way, that you don't exclude people, because I'm afraid I'm not very good at picking a top three comments kind of thing, because I would feel, it wouldn't feel right, so to say, if you get my drift. Let's speed you up a little bit. No, let's just press play, because I also want to buy buses. I want to go for the biggest buses, so not these ones. 140 at 65. 100. You can have. Let's make you blue. 4. Okay. Then pick you. Cancel. Well, no, I'm clicking here. All right. Oh, you're working for Soviet Custom House. We'll go there. Oh, you weren't. Oh, yeah, you weren't. Why? Oh. Sorry for that. Oh, yeah. Okay. That makes sense. Okay. So, you go here. Here. Unload there. Load. You. Unload. Let's go. Again. Go. Okay. Cancel. Okay. That's the one. Okay, now are the vehicles which I wanted here yet? No, because you're waiting here somewhere. Yeah. Hurry up. So yeah, the road to Amsterdam next episode. I'm waiting for the vehicles to arrive so I can set the correct import stuff. And then we're going to import, and then we can start creating our blueprint. We have steel already here. Yeah, we have 70s. We have for half a ship steel already, which is good. Which is good. Created by us. Only need one. This one. No. Okay, excellent. So now you're getting fuel, because there's no fuel here. Okay, what again do we need to load? We need to load plastics, and we need to load fabric, and we need to load mechanical components and electronics, and unload. I am going to say to only unload there, and this can be like 80%, so something like that. In future, hopefully the near future, most of these, except for the fabric, are going to be loaded from here. So, this is done. And I think that also concludes our episode. Did I go over all the comments? Ethan also said, you might want to have more parallel roads in your town. It looks like all the traffic gets routed through the roundabout. Yes, I call this my city skylines problem, where all traffic gets routed. It is a good idea, because it's the only road. I do want to have to think this over, and I think a great one would be to remove this one altogether, somehow route a road like so, if I can get between you here or something. I don't know. I have to think about, it's not a bad idea, like so. And then go like here, and then somewhere join here, something like that. With asphalt, of course. I think that's a better idea than this this mess. But look, go. What's keeping you? Nothing. Uh, I'm not really annoyed by the win. Well, it's a little bit the roundabout. It's a little bit the politeness of the Soviet drivers, so to say. Anyway, I'm going to leave this episode. I'm looking forward to your comments on how you would like this with the reading of comments. I really enjoy doing it, but I also can understand you saying, well, it's taking up a chunk of the playtime. We are getting our first. What are you going to do? Plastics! Plastic Fantastic, here we are again. Thank you for watching. I hope you have a nice day. And next time I want to talk to you about these embankments and turning on day and night cycle, because I wanted to do it when it's November, when it's winter. And then I would love to have these lighted. So I have been planning for that, like the last, this substation here. It reaches all of there. So yeah. Again, bye-bye.